This is a real train built in 1880 something, Dixiana. Sorry, this is gonna be pretty loud. Returning. Redwood. Redwoods, some of the biggest and oldest trees in the world. There's a lot of them in Yosemite National Park. It's a dead end. Oh, we're going backwards. We're going back.
And then on the left-hand side in this direction of travel, and you're facing the hillside, just past the switch on that little mossy hillside, there is a banana slug, so keep an eye out for it. And now keeping in mind that rise over run formula I said earlier, we're now beginning to back up an 11% grade. So for every 100 feet we go forward, we're going up about 11 feet, making this the steepest set of narrow gauge tracks in North America. And making Dixiana back there arguably one of the hardest working steam engines in North America, as it is no easy task going up an 11% grade, let alone backwards. Although these engines were built for this kind of thing, really put them to the test here at a long time, this railroad is completely sharp for turns and steep for grades, which probably would have existed on most logging railroads this type of engine would serve. And Dixiana is probably working way harder now than it would have if it was first built, and that's because on logging and mining railroads, typically take empty cars up the mountain, fill them with whatever you're harvesting, and put them down when they pull off. But on this railroad here at Roaring Plains, you go up those cars full of people and down those cars full of people, so Dixiana gets no grade. And it also takes a very talented crew to be able to do that. Back on that engine that you're facing from the seat now, on the left-hand side, you have the fireman who controls the steam pressure in the boiler, which is the first to see the fire in the water station. And on the right-hand side of the locomotive, you have the engineer. The reason that steam pressure is created by the fireman is because there is a huge break in the direction of the train, which is the
motor. It's like a dog panting.
And we have made it to Hallelujah Junction. And this location is called Hallelujah Junction because when they first put in that switch back in 1976, it took them 9 attempts to back up that ladder track, the diagonal part of the Z we just backed up. And on the final attempt, when they finally made it up here, the engineer reached over to the radio and exasperatedly yelled, "Hallelujah!" And the name stopped. And that name does still apply today, as we don't always make it up in one try. On especially rainy days, when there's water on the rails, you may not be able to get enough traction backing up that switchback, and you may have to roll back down, build up more steam, and try again. I haven't been on a train that's seen multiple attempts yet, but I know some of our conductors have been on trains that took 4 attempts to make it up that ladder track. But we made it up in one today, so hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Going forward?
Where are we going?
Going up. Thank you.
Perfect place to start his drink.